Susan.
And I'm Jerry.
And we are Just One More. Thanks so much for joining us today, everyone. We are so excited that you're here. It's been 2 weeks.
Yep.
And we want to just finish up a little bit about our trip from Albuquerque and just to end up Albuquerque.
Really. Yeah.
We had a really great couple days when we were just kind of doing things instead of crewing on the balloon, right?
Kind of relaxed a little bit. Crewing is hard work. It's a lot of labor.
It was, we were cheap labor is what we were.
Yes, we were.
Yeah, but it was fun. I mean, we got to go up in the balloon and it was really a wonderful experience. So when we were at the RV park in Albuquerque in the mornings, for the first time we experienced the balloons landing.
The balloons landing around us.
Right, all around us. That was the craziest thing.
You'll have video of that. It's pretty cool.
It's very cool.
So here's a different view from the RV park and all the balloons. And they're landing again all around us. Oh, this guy. Okay, so this guy just took off again. That's bizarre. Okay. These guys are way too close to the power lines over there. That's very, very scary. But you can kind of get an idea of what we go through every morning here. And this is our last morning.
And then we went to downtown, Old Town, which was really, really nice. We actually ran into a store, just by chance, and it was David Brehns, B-E-H-R-E-N-S.
Gallery.
And this guy was hysterical. He is half Jewish and half Italian. And we just kind of connected. And he has beautiful things. He has some beautiful things in there.
And he spent some time in New York, too. So.
Yeah, his family's from New York, actually. But he showed us around his store, and he's an artist. And he was truly, truly talented.
Very inspiring. We took a video of his store.
Yeah.
Interviewed him, and he's very, very encouraging and exciting. If you can stop there, stop into his store.
Yeah, if you're ever in Albuquerque, it's really a cool thing to do. Okay, hi everyone. Just one more here, Susan and Jerry. We are out in Old Town Albuquerque, and we walked into this fabulous gallery, and David is the owner and artist, and we'll take some shots of the art that David's done. But why don't you tell us a little about your store?
So, first of all, you guys walked in and I just felt like a connection. I felt like we were like same three different branch, which is wonderful.
Yeah, but I felt the same way, actually.
Yeah, plus we're both Jewish.
Hello!
So how could that be wrong? So my story is that the art that I arrived with is very different from my ethnicity. And I, after thinking about it for a long time, I do Native American art. And I am not even 1% Native American, but what it does, it expands my heart, because, when you open your heart to other cultures, you become inclusive, like everything matters, everything like puzzle pieces fits together. And when we're separated, we only hurt ourselves.
Wow.
So let me show you a couple
show us
of my
around.
Pieces. So, I'm David Brehns. I wanted to show you a couple of my paintings and give you a little bit of background to what I'm doing. This is my newest piece, and it's kind of off the beaten path for me. I normally do a lot of Southwestern and Plains Indian art, but this is a painting I did about the Alaska Indigenous people. And the Alaskan people, they don't come to the forefront when you think of Native American. You think of Navajo, you think of Hopi, you think of Cherokee. But the seed to this idea was, I was imagining the relationship of Native people to the land and how precious that is and how timeless that is. And so what I have here is, what I imagined was the first time an Inuit or Athabascan or one of the tribes saw the northern lights and saw them shimmering or kind of raining down from the sky. Translucent, all I could think of is the word divine, and there's things in this world that are so beautiful that words don't express that. I'll show you one more piece. I had no idea I was going to get such a following with this piece, but I sell it all over the country. I've sold it to many, many, you know, places overseas. But basically, it's called Original Founding Fathers, and it's a paradigm shift. So the concept is that why are we conditioned to think of the presidents when we hear founding fathers? But you know, it's like a kink in our thinking, and we do that with lots of things. So I thought to myself, I'd like to put the ones who are deserving. And many times people ask me, why did you choose these? And the reason I chose them is because they personally touched me, you know. Chief Joseph, Sitting Bull, Geronimo, and Red Cloud. Incredible leaders, incredible elders that cared about their people more than they cared about themselves. So anyway, thank you so much for listening, and I hope you have an incredible rest of your day.
Nice guy, really nice guy. And then we left.
Hit the road.
We hit the road after being in Albuquerque 11 days.
Yeah.
Couldn't wait to get to a full hookup.
Yeah.
Because if you've been reading my blog, boondocking is still out for me. The jury's still out.
Okay.
I'm boondocking.
I understand.
But we're going to get more solar
down
the road, and when we go to Lake Havasu later in the year. So we'll see. I'll keep you posted on that. But we stopped. Our very first stop was in
Clovis, New Mexico.
Listen, this was a random place. You have to understand, when I go on these the RV Trip Wizard site to find places, this was random. I had no idea.
So what was special about Clovis? Turns out it's a very, 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 very big train depot.
Yeah.
All night long. There were trains going north all night long.
With the train. We didn't sleep.
North, south, east, west. We didn't sleep very well.
But it was, here's the thing about it. It was so convenient because it was right off the
Right on the highway.
And it was lovely.
And it was great.
Clean,
really level.
And a full hookup.
Full hookup.
Where we actually got to take long showers.
Hot showers.
And so we didn't sleep much. But the nice thing is, the next day we left to Albuquerque, and it was only about a 5-hour drive. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
We just entered Texas.
Welcome home.
We are finally in Texas. We are on our way to Albuquerque for the night. It's about a 4.5-hour drive today. So then we'll spend the night in Abilene, and then tomorrow we will head into Austin. We're so excited. So let's talk about our little stay in Clovis, New Mexico. The RV place, the Travelers World RV Park, was right off the highway.
Yep. Very convenient. Very, very spacious. Well laid out. Plenty of room. Pull through.
Clean.
Clean.
Very clean.
The bathrooms were spick and span.
You know, it was just a really nice little place. It was only $35 to stay there with full hookups. That's the key, full hookups.
But there was one little problem.
Yeah.
If you love trains, this is for you. But this is a major terminal to freight trains, and it was 24/7. All night long.
Yeah. I had my earplugs in. So. So at least I got some sleep. But again, it was a very convenient and very inexpensive but very nice little RV park. In fact, I said this morning it was one of the nicest RV parks that we've stayed in for one night, just a quick one-nighter. We'll see what happens now, but we're going to Whistler Stop. We'll see what happens there. Get back to you later. Here's the rule.
5 hours.
Here's the rules.
Here's the rule.
300 miles.
300 miles.
Or... 5 hours.
5 hours.
Must get to the campground no later than 3 p.m.
3 p.m.
And we never, ever drive at night.
Dark. No dark driving.
No.
We're old farts.
I don't care how old you are. You shouldn't drive at night in these things.
It's tough.
It's tough. So we got to Abilene.
Abilene.
And
what did we do in Abilene? What is our first thing we did?
We needed food, and I didn't feel like cooking. So what did we do? We went to...
Cowboy Barbecue, our first Texas barbecue. And Texas barbecue is beef, brisket. They did have some pork ribs, and our eyes were much bigger. We had food for the next day, and it was excellent. And we rated it, what, 7?
We rated
eight?
It, No, it was like between 7 and 8.
Yeah.
For those of you who we're talking about, Jerry and I are KCBS,
Kansas City Barbecue Society. We're not current yet because of COVID, but we'll sign back up.
But we're barbecue judges.
BBQ judges.
So we kind of
We
kind of know our barbecue.
Well, so we know the standard that KCBS holds people to.
And we also know by taste, too, and what we're looking for. But it was very, very good. It
Excellent.
Was really, really good. So that was the highlight of Abilene, Texas, because we immediately left the next day. And this road to Texas, or to Austin, was all back roads.
Yeah.
I mean,
country.
It was so beautiful.
So what were the three things we kept seeing, Susan?
We kept seeing cotton fields.
Cotton fields.
We kept seeing the windmills.
The windmills.
And we kept seeing oil.
Oil.
Drills.
Oil drills.
Cotton.
Oil.
And the windmills.
And windmills.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We are on our way to Austin.
What is this, day three?
Yeah, this is day three.
Okay.
Yeah. We just spent the night in Abilene. Really nice campground.
Very nice campground. Except for the 500 mile an hour wind.
Yeah, we had some major wind last night. Some rain came down, but the wind stayed with us for about 4 or 5 hours. A little different when you're in an RV, just letting you know. When you are in an RV, wind is a little scary, I just have to say.
The trailer was a rocket and it wasn't from...
having too much fun. And the traffic. We were right off the main highway.
Highway 20, right?
Yeah, Highway 20. So it was a little loud. It was just a little loud.
Truckers all night long.
All night long.
No, no.
But we did go out for a fabulous barbecue.
Oh, man, I can't wait. We got leftovers.
Yeah.
Oh, man, that was a good barbecue. We're going to start a little segment of Rate That Texas Barbecue.
Yeah, we're gonna rate Texas Barbecue. And the other one we're going to rate is Tex-Mex, right?
Tex-Mex.
Yeah, Katie's got a lot of Mexican restaurants and a taco tour that she wants to take us on. So we will be driving for the next 4 hours to get to Austin. Who knows what's going to happen between now and then? All kinds of fun things could, you know? We could pass all kinds of stuff. Right now we're in the middle of nowhere. Just passing a bunch of different ranches. A lot of different ranches. We're definitely taking the back roads.
It's pretty out here.
It's really pretty. And what's really nice is we're not amongst a bunch of traffic.
Yeah.
So that kind of makes a very, very nice drive. And the roads are not so horrible. So anyway, on our way to Austin.
Bye.
Okay, I do have to tell the story about pulling into where we are right now. So the GPS gave us some very interesting directions. And my poor husband... pulled us following these directions into a neighborhood that the streets were this narrow to get to our RV campground. I am telling you, the oh shit handle was
by the time we got here, there's like 50 cars behind us, but yeah. Nobody was honking because you know we weren't doing too much damage.
No, he didn't scrape anything, he didn't lose anything,
so
and we got here just fine.
Guess what? We're gonna do when we leave,
not
we're gonna go look. We're going to go look at the path out of here before we hook up and look at it.
We're
you know?
Not going that
and,
way.
And find out if we can trust it or not.
Yeah, it was weird. This RV trip wizard has never let us down.
But it was an adventure, right? High five.
Okay.
When we checked in at the RV show.
Oh, my God. No, let me tell the story.
Okay.
So I'm checking us in, and all of a sudden, Jerry comes to the register with this much beer and whatever else he could find.
I'm like,
I need
really
a cocktail.
Thirsty. I'm really thirsty.
Oh, my God.
It was a little stressful.
He was a lot more stressful.
But nobody died.
Nobody died and nothing was hurt.
Okay.
But we're here.
Yes, we are.
And we love this place. It's called La Hacienda RV Resort.
The nicest RV resort that nobody's heard of that we have ever stayed at.
Yeah, it has a pool. It has a putting green and a chipping green.
Yeah.
It has a playground for kids.
Take a walk.
It's very big. And there's a lot of
full-time
people who live here.
Yeah.
But it's very nice.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of very expensive RVs all around us.
What's the Sun Resorts?
It's called
of the Sun Resorts.
Part of the Sun Resorts, which we didn't know that we were here.
Was a thing.
Yeah,
you know?
But it's really nice, and I really encourage you to take a look at it. It's really a lot of fun.
We are at the La Hacienda Sun RV Resort in Austin, Texas. And this is the first chance we've had to get out because it was pouring all morning, and yesterday we went over to Katie's, so we really didn't get a chance to look around. Oh, and there's Jerry. What is Jerry doing? He's just rocking. This is the laundry and showers room. It's really quite nice with these fabulous chairs. We're going to be taking a walk around and checking it all out, and we'll be getting back to you too. And that's the dog park over there, so it's very, very nice. They even have a workout room. Yep, there's Jerry. Isn't that nice? I mean, this is really a nice, it's probably, as of right now, the nicest RV park we've stayed at, don't you think? Yeah, it's pretty cool. They even have a putting green here and a playground for kids. We are in the pavilion of La Hacienda Resort, and this is called the Freddie Powers Pavilion. So if any of you know who Freddie Powers is, please do us a favor and let us know, because we don't. But this is a cool part. Got all kinds of fun things. It's got pool tables and tables and all kinds of things. Yeah, I have no clue. Never heard of them. Maybe we're missing out on something. There's some games over here. Yeah, kind of interesting place. Of course, the bathrooms. Pretty, pretty cool.
Honey, I'm so excited. I gotta talk about something.
Well, first of all, we gotta talk about Katie.
Okay, Katie.
Because Katie is here.
Okay, we're talking about Katie.
Katie is here, and that's the reason we're here, basically,
yep.
For as long as we are. We're here until November 19th, and it's just been so much fun having Katie here, and then we've been going over to her apartment, and then...
And Tito.
And of course, Tito.
Little Tito. We're going to babysit him.
We're going to babysit him in a couple weeks, because Katie's going to go back to U of A for homecoming. But talking about college. Tell us what happened for you.
As a Texas off on you. I got to go to a University of Texas football game. Katie introduced me to somebody who actually played on the football team, and since you played on the football team and you lettered, you get tickets for life.
Yeah.
So at halftime we went in, and I gotta say, I was more than thrilled. I teared up at times because I was in the stadium that was just unbelievable. They lost, but so
but
what?
You had a great time.
I had a great time. I was there in 1976, and I amazed my friend who got me into the game with some facts about it. He goes, how did you know that? I said, I was here in 76. He goes, yeah, okay, all right.
And,
so,
and the friend's name is John, and he's a friend of Katie's.
Good guy.
And he invited us as well to their tailgating, which is a very interesting thing here in Austin.
they take it serious.
They do. I mean, there's places everywhere in downtown that people are putting elaborate tailgate parties together.
And it's their permanent tailgate spot.
It's their permanent spot. And while Jerry was in the game, I was playing Flip Cup with Katie and her friends, and guess what? We won.
She won.
So it was just a lot of fun. I mean, we just had the best time with them.
Oh,
we
man.
Really did.
Hook 'em horns.
Hook 'em horns. And then yesterday we went on our very first bike ride.
A long bike ride.
Yeah.
Almost 7 miles.
Yes, together with our electric bikes, which we absolutely
love. But we did pedal.
Yeah, and then Katie was here too over the weekend too, and she was riding the bike around, and she was thought, oh, it's just a bike, and then she got on and she's going, I went up to 20 miles an hour. And what's interesting, cars can only go 10 miles an hour here, but we were going up to 20 in the park, so we had a really good time. We went to Walnut Creek Park, and it
nice
was just
park.
Really pretty.
There
it's
a lot
just
of parks
very,
here
very pretty
Austin.
Here. All right, so we're going bike riding today. We're going on the Northern Walnut Creek Trail. It's 3.2 miles to Walnut Creek Metro Park. That's where we're heading. So this should be a very interesting time.
We made it to the Walnut Creek Park. So now we're going back. It was 3.2 miles, obviously. So now we're going to go back and we're going to
So we're just having really a great time. We are just enjoying
Very
Austin
relaxing
right now.
There.
Yeah. Well, we had a storm.
Oh.
The second night we were here, you guys.
God. It was a Texas storm.
It was a Texas storm with the
wind
lightning.
Was going like this.
Yeah.
And the rain was going like this, and the lightning was going. I'm getting underneath the covers.
Yeah, it was unbelievable.
We didn't sleep that night.
No, you open up the window and it was just constant lightning and the thunder was over us. Well, what's interesting is the erosion here in the park from the rain.
Yeah.
Some of the grounds, the campgrounds, there's dirt everywhere.
Yeah.
It was massive.
It was a big storm. It was part of that Pamela storm that
came
from
Mexico.
From Cabo.
Yeah.
Cabo.
But here's the thing too. It's always louder in an RV. Just telling you. The rain pedaling, the thunder, it was definitely louder than being in a home.
Yeah. Thunder.
Yeah, it was crazy. Thunder. But other than that, the weather has been great now, and we're really excited. We're going to be doing the South of Congress, the Domain. We have a lot to do here in Austin, and you'll see us in a couple weeks with more from Austin. So thanks so much for tuning in, but please make sure that you give us a thumbs up if you like this video. And you know my whole story, if you don't like it, too bad. And, oh well.
You can get your money back.
Yeah, exactly.
Love you guys.
And please subscribe to make sure that every other Thursday that you get notification, okay? That's ring that little bell. Thanks so much for joining us. What's our just one more this week?
Just one more week of relaxing and having fun and exploring Austin.
Absolutely. That's a good one. Just one more time in Austin. Thanks everyone for coming and joining us.
Bye. Love you.